There are tons of hilarious cat videos floating around online, almost like they are defying our understanding of physics. In one of the clips, a white cat is trapped in a glass room. It carefully sizes up the narrow gap between two glass panels. Then, like some kind of system glitch, the cat shoves its head through the slit, followed by its front paws. With a wiggle of its body, the whole cat just flows right out, leaving its buddies next to it staring in shock as if thinking, what on earth is this guy up to? Another video features a tiny kitten ignoring its pals trying to block it. It pokes its head out, and the rest of its body slides out of the container and land with a little bounce. The move is so smooth, it is like an octopus slipping out of a bottle. Then there is this popular one, where an orange cat squeezes through a tiny hole in a cardboard box. Head first, then the body deforms and flows out like liquid, no trouble at all. Even wilder is a long-haired cat, pouring itself into a clear water bottle, curling up into a ball and filling every nook and cranny as if it is truly turned into liquid. Scenes like these may make you wonder, are cats actually liquids? Shockingly, scientists have taken this question seriously, studied it, and come up with an answer. Today, let's dive into the story behind cats' liquefaction. From physics to biology, all the way to the wild ride of evolution. Before we dive into today's exploration, if you are enjoying the content and want to join our community of curious minds, I'd be so grateful if you hit that subscribe button. It truly helps support the channel and keeps us connected. And for even more fun, turn on the notification bell so you never miss a new adventure. Thanks a bunch. All right, let's explore even more. In 2017, the Sanders Theater at Harvard University was buzzing with energy as the annual Ig Nobel Prize ceremony kicked off. This award, started back in 1991, cheekily calls itself the first annual every year, with the goal of making you laugh first, then making you think. It is famous for its humor, but the research behind it is the real deal, legitimate science. For instance, in 2000, physicist Andre Gym won for using magnetic fields to make a frog levitate. It sounded ridiculous, but it paved the way for graphene research, which earned him the actual Nobel Prize in Physics in 2010. Graphene has kicked off a new era in material science, potentially leading to phone batteries that charge in 5 minutes and last for 3 months. At that 2017 first annual ceremony, French physicist Marc-Antoine Fardin snagged the physics prize with his paper on the rheology of cats. He used rheology principles to tackle a seemingly absurd question: can cats be both solid and liquid at the same time? The inspiration came from a 2014 article in an animal magazine that listed 15 pieces of evidence showing cats of various breeds adapting to all sorts of container shapes, from vases to glasses, essentially liquefying to fill the space, while keeping their volume pretty much the same. These images sparked a lot of buzz. Some folks worried it was animal abuse, but cat owners know it is just instinct. Cats love squeezing into tight spots. Rheology studies how materials flow and deform under stress. The ancient Greek philosopher Heraclitus said, "Everything flows," which in Greek is called pantere. Pantere became the philosophical backbone of rheology. Newton categorized matter into solids, liquids, and gases and unified them with mathematical models. A key metric in rheology is the Deborah number, which is equal to relaxation time divided by observation time, where relaxation time is how long it takes for a material to return to its shape, and observation time is the time scale from the observer's perspective. If Deborah number is less than 1, the material acts like a fluid. If Deborah number is greater than, it behaves like a solid. Take the Himalayas as an example. On a human timescale of decades, the relaxation time is way longer than the observation time, since crustal deformation takes millions of years. So Deborah number is huge and it seems solid. But on Earth's billions of years scale, Deborah number is less than 1, and the Himalayas flow like a fluid, explaining plate tectonics moving the mountains. Another example, a water droplet under super high speed camera, which captures 10,000 frames per second, can hold a solid shape briefly when poked. But our eyes can't catch it. Farden applied this framework to cats, analyzing tons of videos to prove their liquid properties. Farden pulled in a bunch of cat videos as examples. In one, a cat fills up a fish tank in 5 seconds with an observation time of 60 seconds. So Deborah number equals to 5 over 60, which is less than 1, fitting fluid behavior. Another shows a long-haired cat slowly flowing into a clear plastic box, its fur expanding to fill every corner, even spreading out like a gas. But when running or jumping cats have Deborah number greater than 1, acting solid, showing they can switch between states, demonstrating a fluid's deformability. Another example is a calico cat squeezing out of a tiny tear in a paper bag. Head pokes out first, then the body deforms and flows out smoothly. No hitches, like liquid ignoring obstacles. In yet another video, a cat flattens itself on a spinning Roomba, molding to the surface, like liquid as it moves, deforming at will. Hilariously, there is one where a cat tries to squeeze out of a litter box's narrow slit. Head and front paws come out first, body jiggles like jelly, and finally, the whole thing slides out, showcasing a fluid's continuity. Farden also found that cats have a rheological axis. Along their body axis, like when picked up by the scruff and stretched long, they can extend 5 to 6 times. Along their off axis, like when flattening on the floor, only 2 to 3 times. This works even without containers. In one video, a cat in a sink stretches along its axis, elongating like a thin strip. Another shows a cat dangling from a clothesline like liquid, dripping down, resembling a long dough. There is even a cat flowing between a cage and the floor, flattening along its axis to fill the tight space. Wettability is another liquid trait. Water beads up on lotus leaves, which means lotus leaves are hydrophobic, but spreads on paper towels, which means paper towels are hydrophilic. Farden noticed cats avoid slick surfaces, like tiles or water, and prefer rough surfaces like carpets, pillows, and keyboards. In a video, a cat curls into a ball on a bamboo basket, like a water drop on a lotus leaf, thanks to the rough surface attracting the liquid cat, while smooth ones repel it. This explains why cats hate water. It is the ultimate slick surface to cat repellent. Non-Newtonian fluids have yield stress, like ketchup, still when squeezed gently, but gushes out if you hit it too hard. In a video, a cat gets stuck in a couch gap. The owner pulls and pulls with no luck, but shifts the angle, and whoosh, the cat flows out, like surpassing the yield stress. Another shows a kitten jammed in a shoe. Tugging does nothing until a light tap on the sole makes the cat slide out like liquid. Turbulence is another liquid feature. When deformation is fast, it creates chaotic motion like vortices. Farden highlights a video of a cat spinning rapidly in a bottle matching turbulence rules, even showing the Weissenberg effect, where the liquid climbs up during stirring. In another clip, a cat twirls a few times in a plastic bottle, then pokes its head out, perfectly illustrating this. Farden concludes that cats aren't passive liquids, but actively change shape. Japanese researchers add that cats absorb environmental stress, like in cat cafes where stressed office workers release tension by petting them. Cats can squeeze through 7 centimeter gaps or ooze out of cabinet cracks, make you wonder if Tom and Jerry was a documentary. Cats can become a bag of cat, a bowl of cat, a tank of cat, even a tube of cat. They are unstoppable. Cats, liquefaction, comes from their unique anatomy. They have 230 to 250 bones, with 44 to 58 vertebrae. Humans only have 206 bones and 26 vertebrae. Cats have large gaps between discs, allowing 180 degree twists or bizarre poses. Shoulder blades attach only by muscle, not fixed to the clavicle, boosting front limb flexibility. Cats' clavicles are small or floating, not restricting movement. Tails help with balance, and their skulls are compact for probing tight spots. A Japanese television show once tested this. In an 8 centimeter wide alley exit, cats use their whiskers to gauge gaps and breeze through. If whiskers fit, body usually does. Dogs often get stuck due to rigid shoulders. Another experiment shrunk a round hole from 20 centimeters to 5 centimeters, and cats still made it, even acing mid-air hole challenges. Kittens' 26 ribs and 8 sternum bones are mobile, letting them flatten like paper. Cats act liquid vertically, but more solid horizontally. All controlled precisely by the brain's muscle and bone coordination. Why do cats love boxes and crevices? It goes back to evolution. About 66 million years ago, an asteroid wiped out the dinosaurs, reshaping Earth's ecosystem. Small mammals like miacids seized the moment, becoming ancestors of carnivorans, including feliforms, ancestors of cats, mongooses, and hyenas. So, hyenas are closer to cat than dog. And caniforms, ancestors of dogs, bears, and pinnipeds. Miacids were cat-sized, hiding in tree hollows or rock crevices by day, to avoid predators, hunting small prey or insects at night. Some miacids left the trees, evolving into caniforms or arctoids like bears, some becoming pinnipeds like seals. Feliforms stayed small and agile. Plot twist: there was an apex predator in the feliforms family. They were able to hunt down mammoths but went extinct in the last ice age due to high prey demands. They are the saber-toothed tigers. After the downfall of saber-tooth, lions and tigers took over as land rulers. However, besides lions and tiger, the black-footed cat is rated the deadliest land predator, with a 60% hunt success rate, where lions only have 20% hunt success rate, nailing a kill every 50 minutes, which is better than cheetahs. But its small size makes it vulnerable, so it hides in rock cracks or burrows by day, active at night. This 60 million year evolution honed cats' superpower. Domestic cats retain this ancestral memory. Boxes, couch gaps, shoes offer security and warmth, mimicking wild hideouts. Even big cats like lions occasionally do similar things. Dogs maxed out pack hunting, bears bulked up on strength, seals evolved into a fish. But cats went all in on agility, becoming flexible, liquid masters. Cats' brains are small, which is only 0.9% of body weight, with 300 to 760 million neurons. But the neurons use 20% of their energy. As efficient as human brains, which is 2 to 3% body weight, with 86 billion neurons, and also consume 20% of energy. This tiny brain constantly calculates every bone and muscle position, ensuring no slips from heights and activating the righting reflex for perfect landings. The cat jumps from high up, instantly adjusting midair for a graceful touchdown, showcasing the brain's precision. Ancient Indian yogis watched cats and noticed their stretches efficiently wake muscles. They mimicked them, creating poses like cat-cow, emphasizing harmony with nature. In a clip, a cat wakes and arches its back, then relaxes, just like yoga. Cats' liquid superpower isn't just physics and biology. It's black box tech for coexisting with the environment. Humans haven't fully domesticated cats. We've been charmed by them instead, maybe a subconscious nod to nature's power. Cat's liquid behavior is a masterpiece of physics, biology, and evolution. From rheology, they are solid or fluid depending on timescales. Biologically, flexible skeletons and nerves let them fit any shape. Evolutionarily, 60 million years of survival instincts shaped their liquefaction. Whether squeezing through box slits, spinning out of bottles, or flowing with robot vacuums. Next time, you see a cat napping in an outrageous pose or wedging into an impossible spot. Don't be shocked. It's the perfect showcase of billions of years of evolutionary wisdom.